This video is made possible by EA Game Changers. Thank you to EA Game Changers for flying me out to the event. It was a lot of fun, and I hope you guys enjoy the video. What's up, guys? MMAGAME here, bringing you another video. In this video, we'll be talking about the Ultimate Team Mode and how to build your team in EA Sports UFC 3. And you don't have to start off playing people online and competing against people who have crazy calves. Instead, you can actually build up your fighters, earn coins, open packs, and you can collect moves all in the single player parts of Ultimate Team, like single player championships and also the new solo challenges. And solo challenges is a new feature in UFC 3. In this mode, you can choose between three different skill levels of challenges: normal, hard, and insane. The tougher the challenge, the better the reward. There's also a practice mode in solo challenges where you can practice your moves and combos. And this is pretty much like a practice mode for Ultimate Team, so you don't have to go all the way back out to the start menu and use that practice mode. You can actually pretty much just use practice mode in Ultimate Team. So that's actually a really handy little thing to use for Ultimate Team. They're getting used to all your moves that you're adding to your fighter, so definitely check out the practice mode within the solo challenge menu. Another new Ultimate Team feature are starter sets. To complete the starter sets and earn the rewards, you will need to trade in the correct cards. So it'll ask you for one silver card, maybe a couple bronze cards, there'll be certain types of cards too, like either contract cards, move cards, perk cards. You have to put the right amount the right type of card in there, and then you redeem them for rewards and tokens that you can use for sets. The gist of this mode is basically you can get rid of all the cards that you're not using. Like in UFC 2, you had tons of cards that you just kept, this huge hoard of cards in this big collection that you really weren't even going to use because they were like 3-star. But in this game, it's a lot of bronze cards that you'll collect or silver cards that you don't really want to use, and then that's when you can go in to the sets area and trade all those cards in for rewards to get even better cards. The other way you can build up your fighters by collecting moves, perks, and increasing your fighter stats is by playing single player championships. By collecting coins and opening packs in single player championships, you will give yourself a better chance at competing online. Because in this mode, you can build up your fighter offline, gain moves, open packs, and get your team where you want it to be before you go ahead and start competing online. There are a lot more new things you can do in UFC 3's Ultimate Team, but those are the basics of what you can do to succeed in Ultimate Team, guys. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to leave a like. Also follow me on Twitch TV and Twitter. Till next time, this has been MMAGAME. Peace.